Big story we're tracking this Friday. Former Haryana Chief Minister Om Prakash Chautala has been busy campaigning for his party while out on medical bail, has been summoned by the Delhi High Court after the CBI asked the court to advance his surrender date. The court expressed disappointment over the fact that Chautala has been addressing election rallies in the poll-bound state after he was granted bail on medical grounds. The CBI had moved the Delhi High Court seeking cancellation of bail granted to Chautala in the teachers recruitment scam case, where Chautala and his son Ajay were found guilty and sentenced to 10 years in prison. If the Delhi High Court decides to cancel Chautala's bail, the decision will have a direct impact on his party's fortunes in the poll-bound state. Let's get in a word from our executive editor, Javed Ansari, who's with us in our studios this morning. Javed Ansari, a crucial verdict, a crucial hearing for Om Prakash Chautala. The court visibly upset with the INLD leader for addressing rallies while out on medical grounds.
Yes, indeed it is. Mr. Chautala was given bail so that he could get himself treated, and he was undergoing treatment at Vedanta. Now suddenly, once the elections were declared, he used this opportunity to go on the campaign trail. He's been stomping around campaigning for his candidates, something which has not gone down well with rival political parties as also the government, and now they've approached the court. Perhaps Mr. Chautala may have seen yesterday might have been his last date of campaigning. This is what legal experts are telling us, because the court is likely to take a dim view of what he has done.
And Javed Ansari, how is this hearing likely to affect his poll fortunes?
I'm not so sure, because he's had about 10 days and he's done what he wanted to. He's done the bulk of the work. He's been campaigning very hard late into the night, holding several meetings, covering large areas in a day. So he's done, the message has gone out. He's managed to appeal to his constituency, and he keeps saying that he went to jail. He's not apologetic about the fact that he's gone to jail. He says, I went to jail because I gave poor people jobs. If I get a chance, I will give 3 lakh people a job. So he's trying to play the role of a political martyr in Haryana.
Absolutely. Om Prakash Chautala trying to milk his conviction in the scam as he woos voters in the poll-bound state. Let's also get in a word from our correspondent Ashish Mehrishi, who's with us live this morning. Ashish, the CBI moving the Delhi High Court, asking the court to cancel Om Prakash Chautala's bail on that he was granted on health grounds, saying he's been making a mockery of the court.
Very true. In fact, you know, Simi, if you would have seen in a number of rallies he has addressed, and the CBI counsel has also questioned the Vedanta Hospital for the reason that they have asked the court to take a decision on Vedanta as well, and direct and try to find out on how is it possible that the doctors allowed a person who is 79 years old and ailing, he's not well, be allowed to go for election rallies. Now this is something very, very serious, that and the court has taken cognizance of. Now today in the morning, as I spoke to his counsel, according to him, he has to appear in a disproportionate asset case first in Tees Hazari at 10 o'clock. So he should have already appeared in Tees Hazari court, and then he comes in Delhi High Court where Justice Mridul is going to Justice Mridul has summoned him to come over and explain on why he misused the the bail that he was given to that was given to him on the medical grounds. Now that is the entire thing, because this is going to be the entire happening in the entire day. So the most important part would be on how the Chautala's supporters are going to behave, because we have seen last time that they the way they behaved outside the court premises was not acceptable. And let us see once he appears in Tees Hazari court and then in High Court, that how his supporters take the entire thing.
Right, Nashish, can you share some details of this disproportionate assets case in connection with which the Tees Hazari court has summoned him?
Well, it was basically in the disproportionate asset case, because during his tenure, there are allegations that he amassed a huge amount of wealth, and after that, once he lost power in Haryana, there was a disproportionate asset case slapped on him. Now, the justice involved into this case, he had asked on how is it possible, because he was given they were asking for exemption from appearance into the court, Tees Hazari court, on the ground that he has been granted bail from the high High Court on medical grounds. But yesterday in the East Azhari Court, the court was very strict on the entire thing. They said that how can we grant exemption in the disproportionate asset case when he's addressing rallies in Haryana? So certainly, let us see how the East Azhari Court takes the entire thing, because he has been misusing the bail of the High Court as well and asking for exemption, in the disproportionate asset case. So let us see, Simi, on how the things move forward in the day.
Absolutely. Let's also get an award from Javed Ansari, our executive editor, who's with us in our studios live this morning. Javed Ansari, the CBI has also said that an explanation should also be sought from the private hospital where Om Prakash Chautala was undergoing treatment. But the court has said that the private hospital cannot be summoned because it's not a party to the case. But fact is that Om Prakash Chautala has openly used this bail to gain political gains.
Yes, and this is a tactic that most politicians use to try and hoodwink. They take bail on medical grounds and then try and violate that by doing what Mr. Chautala has done. Now, the hospital in question treated him for whatever he was ailing from, and after that Mr. Chautala ought to have gone back to jail. But it was for the authorities to have done that, to have ensured that he was sent back to jail. Mr. Chautala still has some time, and therefore he's used that opportunity very cleverly to try and campaign for his candidates.
Javed Ansari and Ashish Maharishi, please stay on with us. Om Prakash Chautala is, we do know, serving a 10-year sentence for his role in the teachers recruitment scam. He's been busy participating in rallies in poll-bound Haryana while out on bail on medical grounds. Headlines today follow Chautala on the campaign trail, and this is what we found.
Out on medical bail, Om Prakash Chautala using his freedom for political purposes, hitting the campaign trail with vengeance. Headlines today followed the out on bail INLD chief on his campaign trail in South Haryana. And we found the grand old man of Haryana politics hopping rallies without any fear of law catching up.
Chautala, who is supposedly sick, is out campaigning for himself as the chief minister and for his party to come in full power.
But the CBI wants his bail cancelled for flouting bail terms. His opponents are gunning for him, but INLD is busy playing victim to the hilt. INLD chief has been on a rally marathon, addressing rallies across the state for 8 to 9 hours daily since the day he got bail.
As far as the political atmosphere of Haryana is concerned, it has completely hotting up before the election race. With camera person Ajay Kumar Sinha and Anil Sehag, Ankit Tyagi for Headlines Today.
And Om Prakash Chautala is expected to appear before the Delhi High Court today after he was summoned personally. The CBI has asked the Delhi High Court to cancel his bail after Om Prakash Chautala was seen addressing multiple rallies in poll-bound Haryana. We have with us in our studios Javed Ansari, also with us Ashish Maharishi, who's with us live from Delhi. Ashish, I want to ask you, Javed Ansari made a very important point that when Om Prakash Chautala claimed that he had recovered and was discharged from the hospital, who was responsible for ensuring that he went back to jail?
Well, in fact, it is the CBI who's responsible for it. If you would have seen the observation of the court, court was not happy with the CBI as well. They said, why did you take so much of time to find out whether, he's misusing the bail or not? So now this is this is on the part of the CBI as well, because the moment they found, it was all over the television that Om Prakash Chautala was campaigning and misusing the bail given to him on medical grounds. So obviously CBI is responsible. But at the same time, if you see, his disproportionate asset case is also appearing, he has to appear in the East Azhari court today, where CBI, this is also being investigated by CBI, where they had actually found, the CBI claims to have found assets worth more than 100 crore rupees, and the case is also against Abhay Chautala as well as Om Prakash Chautala when they were occupying power in Haryana. So now these two cases are certainly going to, occupy the television screens today, because obviously he had to appear at 10 o'clock, and hopefully he should have appeared in Tees Hazari court. And now Justice Mridul's case, Justice Mridul, who is going to hear his contention on why he misused the bail, and the person who summoned him, the justice who summoned him, Chautala is expected to appear in his court post lunch. This is what people in the High Court say. I spoke to his counsel in the morning, and he said that disproportionate asset case, he was trying to take exemption from the court for the reason that they have got bail from High Court on the medical grounds. But yesterday the court was not very happy. The Tees Hazari court was not very happy, and they very clearly said that how is it possible when you are misusing the bail and you're visible on television screens where you are campaigning for your candidates in Haryana, how can we give you exemption? So there are two things, very important things. One, in the disproportionate asset case, he has to appear in Tees Hazari, and then on misuse of bail, which was granted by Delhi High Court, he has to appear in Justice Mridul's court.
All right, Ashish, thanks so much for putting those developments in perspective for us. Javed Ansari, we'll also keep coming back to you for more political updates. Opponents there in Haryana extremely worried about Chautala, still seeing him as a powerful contender.